morning and welcome back, everybody. This is an exciting day. It is our second annual talent show here at Waynedale.
Hello, my name is Gabe, and I am part of the KWOL TV crew here at Waynedale. Over the course of the show, we will be taking breaks in the talent to openly discuss many problems we face here in Indiana, specifically the ability to pronounce words or terms. This is not meant to be hurtful to anyone, and if you or a loved one near you suffers from this debilitating condition, we want you to have hope that one day you can help them to learn to say these words correctly. In our first scenario, Bryce, Ong, Avant, and myself portray a discussion about a fabulous and tranquil location in and around people's yards. Sometimes these are permanent landforms, and sometimes they form as a result of heavy rain or a busting above ground pool. Regardless of their origin, people in the Midwest cannot say the word creek. Let's have a look.
Hey, Avant, you can come over now. My mom said it was all right. Hey, Gabe, you can come over now. My mom said it was all right. Hey, Ong, you can come over now. My mom said it was all right. Wow, guys, that was almost as fast as Jimmy John's. Come on in. How y'all like my new house?
Nice.
Sweet.
Cool.
It's big.
Yeah, man, I even got a little creek in my backyard.
Wait, what?
Looky there, see the itty-bitty creek?
You two mean creek, right?
Yeah, I'm not sure what a creek is other than the one you get in your neck from sleeping the wrong way.
You know what a creek is? We learn about them from the fabulous fourth grade teachers at Waynedale Elementary School.
Yeah, remember they taught us that it was a naturally formed stream of water caused by the erosion of the land. In my yards, dudes!
Oh, yeah! I know
what a creek.
Right, a creek.
Died deep.
Space for both my hands. Should've known you were
was trouble from the first kiss. Had your eyes wide open. Why were they open? Gave you all I had and you tossed it in the trash. You tossed it in the trash, you did. To give me all your love is all I ever ask. Cause what you don't understand is I catch a grenade. Jump in front of a train for ya. You know I'd do anything for ya. Oh, oh, I would go through all this pain. Take a bullet straight through my brain. Yes, I would die for ya, baby. But you won't do the same. Hey, when you get back to where you're from, bad woman, bad woman, that's just what you are. Yeah, you smile in my face and rip the brakes out my car. Gave you all I had and you tossed it in the trash. You tossed it in the trash, you did. To give me all your love is all I ever ask. Cause what you don't understand is I catch a grenade.
In our next installment, we explore a world that has befuddled many travelers who have visited Indiana. Did you know that many Hoosiers cannot say the word male correctly? When corrected, they don't realize they are mispronouncing it. In this next skit, we showcase just that situation. We hope you enjoy.
Hey, Elisa, the mail has arrived. Can you run outside and get it for me?
The what has arrived?
The mail. Go get it, please.
It arrives. What on earth is mail and how does it arrive?
It arrives by mail carrier.
You mean mail carrier?
Yeah, that's what I said.
So you mean you want me to go get the mail?
Confound it. Yeah, that's also what I said. The mail has arrived, the flag is down, and the mailbox is full. I can see the mail sticking out.
Wait, what?
The mail has arrived, the flag is down, and the mailbox is full because you can see the mail sticking out.
Yes, that's what I've been trying to tell you.
Well, geesh, Dad, you don't have to be so grumpy, and how do you know what I was thinking?
I'm your dad. I get paid to know what it is.
been on my mind. I grow fonder every day, lose myself in time. Just thinking of your face, God only knows why it's taking me so long to let my doubts go. You're the only before. Every feeling, every word, I imagined it all. You'll never know if you'll never try to forgive your past and simply be mine. I dare you to let me be your one and only. Promise I'm worth it to hold in your arms. So come on and give me a chance to prove I'm the one who can walk that mile until the end starts. If I've been on your whichever road I choose, you'll go. I don't know why I'm scared, 'cause I've been here before. Every feeling, every word, I imagined it all. You'll never know if you'll never try to forgive your past and simply be mine. I dare you to let me be that mile until we get inside.
A boy of anguish now, he's a man of soul. Traded in his misery for the lonely life of the road. Years were cruel to him, no, he won't let them go. Lays awake trying to find the man inside to pack his bags and escape this world. I've never been so torn up in all of my life. I should have seen this coming.
do they like you? You don't have to try.
Isn't it crazy how we see the world in every which way? Saying, OMG, I just like to live in New Orleans one day, one day. I'm a light in the dark. I'm your map through the maze. I'm a sparkle and a diamond, and I'll light up your face, yeah. Just saying, OMG, I just like to live in New Orleans one day, one day. You know I had a dream to go to New Orleans, and I'm finally there. I'm finally at the top, and I never, ever, ever drop. 'Cause I'm saying, OMG, I just like to live in New Orleans. I'm just saying, OMG, it's just so crazy. Yeah.
Gems will always save the day,
and if you think we can't,
we'll always find a way. That's for the people on this world believing. Garnet, amethyst, and pearl, and Steven.
People of Waynedale, are you aware that some people in Indiana cannot pronounce the word wash correctly? Oh, I see by a few of our adults in the back that this one may be a little close to home. What do you say, Miss Shimp? Anyway, here's an example. You know how you might have to wash your clothes, or you have to go wash your hands, or your dad or mom might say, I'm going to run my car to the car wash. Sounds normal enough, right? Well, in this next skit, this particular problem exists in many households in Indiana, especially with the few adults here at Waynedale.
Jaleese, would you go mine into your room and make sure all your clothes are in the hamper? I need to wash the clothes.
Okay, Mom, but I don't think I need anything washed.
Are you being serious right now, or are you pulling my leg?
Why would I be pulling your leg?
Because I asked you to get your dirty laundry, and you said you didn't need anything washed.
Yeah, I take you have a problem with that.
Well, a little. You know it's pronounced wash, right?
But that's what I said. I don't have any dirty laundry to wash.
Would you just go get your laundry?
Sure, Mom.
You better do something with your daughter.
Why? What was that all about?
I just asked her to get her dirty laundry, and she said she didn't. I need to wash the clothes.
Oh, well, I'll say something about obeying you. Hey, I'm going to go down to the car wash. It's pretty dirty. It needs a bath.
You mean car wash?
That's what I said.
After all these years, and I never notice it, so that's where she gets it from.
Gets what from?
Oh, never mind.
Stay with me a minute, I swear I'll make it worth it. Can't you forgive me, at least just temporarily? I know that this is my fault, I should have been more careful. And I know, no, 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 she gives you everything, but boy, I couldn't give it to you. And I know, no, 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 that you got everything, but I got nothing here without you, baby. Swear I'll make it worth it, babe. Cause I don't wanna be without you. So one last time, I need to be the one who takes you home. One more time, my promise after that, I'll let you go. Thank you.
anybody else. Hey, you made me insecure. Tell me I wasn't good enough. So who are you to judge? When you're a diamond in a rough, I'm sure you got something you like to change about yourself. But when it comes to me, I wouldn't want to be anybody else. Na 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 na. I know the degree, I'm the beautiful. Na 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 na. You got every right to a beautiful life. Come on, who says you're not perfect? Who says you're not worth it? Who says you're the only one that's hurting? Trust me, that's the price of beauty.
Thank you. King Fox versus Godzilla versus Tokyo. Someone stabbed Fox, Godzilla blows fire, Tokyo blows up, and the only thing left standing is Tazam!
What did the wall say to the other wall?
I don't know.
Nothing.
Rose?
Knock, knock.
Who's there?
Annoying cow.
Annoying cow who?
Moo.
How did the creature get across the bridge?
I don't know.
Flew.
Hello, moms, dads, grandparents, and other family members. In our next scenario, we explore the veggie names of tomato and potato. Yes, even in suffocated circles, some people say these two words incorrectly. Then again, maybe we say them incorrectly. Let's check it out.
I'm hungry, sweetheart. Do you want a tomato sandwich?
You mean tomato?
Yes, dear, that's what I said, tomato. Wonderful, thank you. I'm kind of in the mood for some potato salad. Would you mind handing me the potatoes from the bin?
Have you ever considered taking English classes?
Why, yes. Yes, I have. Would you mind being a dear and just handing me the potato?
No, if you can't say it right, then I'm not getting you the potato.
I don't even want to know what's going on in there. And I know I'm going to regret saying this, but what's the problem?
Mom is saying tomato and potato.
How do you say it?
Potato and tomato, duh.
Oh my gosh.
Why are you guys fighting in here? I'm trying to study.
Sorry, Dana, but these two weirdos can't say tomato and potato correctly. Help us out. How do you say them?
Potato and tomato, duh, like the rest of us normal people.
Thank you. Someone who can finally say it correctly.
Driving last Friday on the way to Cincinnati on a snow white Christmas Eve. Going home to see her mama and her daddy with the baby in the back seat. 50 miles to go and she was running low on faith and gasoline. It'd been a long, hard year. She had a lot on her mind and she didn't pay attention. She was going way too fast. Before she knew it, she was spinning on a thin black sheet of glass. She saw both her lives flash before her eyes. She didn't even have time to cry. She was so scared. She threw her hands up in the air. Jesus, take the wheel. Take it from my hands. 'Cause I can't do this on my shoulder and the car came to a stop. She cried when she saw that baby in the backseat sleeping like a rock. And for the first time in a long time, she bowed her head to pray. She said, I'm sorry for the way I've been living my life. I know I've got to change. So from now on tonight, Jesus, take the wheel.
this world could ever bring them down. Yeah, they're invincible, but she's just in the background. And she says, I wish that I could be like the cool kids, cause all the cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could be like the cool kids, like the cool kids. A big smile, but they haven't got a clue. Yeah, they're living a good life, can't see what he is going through. They're driving fast cars, but they don't know where they're going. They're in the fast lane, living life without knowing. And he says, I wish that I could be like the cool kids, cause all cool kids, they seem to fit in. I wish that I could be like the cool kids, like the cool kids. I wish that I could be like the cool kids, cause all cool kids, they seem to get in. I wish that I could be like the cool kids, like the cool kids.
she's on fire. Hotter than a fantasy. Lonely like a highway. She's living in a world and it's on fire. Feeling like catastrophe. But she knows she can fly away. Oh, she got both feet on the ground and she's burning it down. Oh, she got her head in the clouds and she's not backing down. This girl is on fire.
Duff, 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 duff it was a fever. A cold, sweaty, high-headed,
a cold, sweaty, high-headed believer.
Ladies and gentlemen, our final scenario depicts a commonly mispronounced word. This hits more at home than you think. In my own family, that's Mr. Luckett talking, this word is pronounced three different ways. I say it correctly. My wife, she says it correctly. And my four-year-old son, he pronounces it a third way. This has caused many arguments in our home, and as I'm sure you can imagine, since I'm not from Indiana, I figured this must be a Hoosier thing. Maybe you disagree. So we decided to put it to you. We need your help settling this little Hoosierism for the pronunciation of the word milk.
Man, I'm thirsty.
Hey, Haley, would you mind tossing me a carton of milk?
You want a carton of what?
I want a carton of milk.
We don't have any cartons of milk, but I do see a carton of milk.
That's what I asked you to get me.
No, you didn't.
Yes, I did. I want that carton of milk.
And as I said before, we don't have any milk. All I see is milk in this crate.
But that's exactly what I asked for. Toss me a carton of milk.
No, you are saying it wrong. This carton is filled with milk, not milk.
Holy cow, that's precisely what I keep asking you to grab me.
No, say milkshake.
Milkshake.
Now good, now what comes from cows?
Unpasteurized milk.
Dude, that is so wrong.
Would you just get the guy a carton of milk?
Wait, a carton of what?
Milk!
Now you both are saying it wrong.
That's what we are both saying. We just want a carton of milk.
Yeah, I want some milk to wash this delicious lunch down.
It's milk.
Milk.
Malk.
Thank you.
Dig this.
Break it down.
오빤 강남 스타일. 강남 스타일. 오빤 강남 스타일. 강남 스타일. 오빤 강남 스타일.
Volume, pump up the volume, pump up the volume.
For the first time in forever, there'll be magic, there'll be fun.
This is a journey into sound.